I'd like to thank the organizers for giving this important chance. At first, let's recall some definitions. At first, as you see there, a weighted homogeneous surface singularity is a normal surface singularity. With a sister action, and if we denote this singularity by spec of some ring, then this ring should be graded, and it is known that its minimal resolution looks like star shape. That means it has a node at the center. It may have some genus, and it has some legs. And its legs is a rational minimal resolution graph of cyclic quotient singularities. And the rational homolytic smoothing is a smoothing topologically simplest. That means a rational homology disk smoothing is a smoothing of a normal surface singularity whose Miller fiber say M is a rational homology disk. That is, it is a smoothing of our singularity over some small disk delta, such that its Miller fiber, that means its general fiber over non-zero point, has rational cohomology, same with the rational homology with four disk. That means it is zero for all I greater than or equal to one. So my question.
This is not necessarily a hypersurface singularity.
Pardon?
Don't assume that it's a hypersurface.
No.
Why?
Is it a hypersurface?
Yeah.
The question is it a
hypersurface? The question was because it's weighted homogeneous, they thought there is an equation. But this means that there is a sister action.
You don't know what I thought. I'm just asking, are you assuming not necessarily?
Yeah. I just assume that our singularity is normal surface singularity. Then I want to classify deformations of weighted homogeneous surface singularity with this kind of very special smoothing, rational homology disk smoothing. At first, we may start with a conjecture raised by Golla. More generally, let our surface X0 is a rational surface singularity. Then, roughly speaking, Golla's conjecture says this one. This is a rough version. That means there is a one-term correspondence between irreducible components. Of a partial deformation space of this X0, a reduced. And some very special partial resolution of this singularity, so-called P modifications. Let me remind you the definition of P modifications now. Yeah. A P modification say Y0 is a partial resolution. A partial resolution of this X0. And it may normal or it may be non-normal, such that it satisfies two conditions. The first one is the singularity on Y0 should be very special. That means every singularity, say Y0P on Y0, should have a Q-Greenstein smoothing. And its canonical divisor should be ample. That means E times KY0 should be positive for every exceptional curve. Of this partial resolution. Then, Golla's conjecture can be interpreted as follows. For instance, if we have a smoothing of given singularity denoted by this notation, this is a smoothing of x0 to a general 5 over xt. For any smoothing, there is a P modification Y0 of X0 such that its Q-Greenstein smoothing of each singularity of Y0 gives us a new 5 over IT, and since they are smooth, we have equality here. That means any smoothing of X0 comes from the Kubernetes-Stein deformation of Y0. So for this conjecture, there are only few cases which this conjecture holds. And the other cases we don't know yet. Here is a theorem by Ola and Shepard-Varen. It is, at first, for quotient surface singularity, Ola conjecture holds. Quotient surface singularity. That means any smoothing of quotient surface singularity comes from P modification. And on this P modification of quotient surface singularity, there can be only very special singularities on Y0. That is, any quotient surface singularities, since we give this condition, it should have a Kubernetes-Stein smoothing with Kubernetes-Stein smoothing should be a rational double point or class T singularity. That is, it is a cyclic quotient singularity of type 1 over Tn scale, 1 Tna minus 1. Here, T should be greater than or equal to 1. And N and A are relatively prime. Let me give you a brief example, this one. For example, suppose we are given a 1 over 19.17 singularity whose minimal resolution graph is over there. Then it has three P resolutions. The one, we contract this minus 2 curve in the minimal resolution. Then we have a partial resolution of this X0. Here, square means we contract that curve. And also, we can contract this minus 4 curve here. And finally, we're blowing up this edge, then we have this configuration. And we contract these two configurations. We can check that the contraction of this one also give us this class T singularity.
The middle one is OP.
Pardon?
Oh, I'm sorry.
It is.
Yeah. So.
So the square boxes.
Yes. Yes.
The contracted curves, and the other ones are.
Yeah. Remains. Yeah.
Exceptional curves.
Yes.
Exceptional.
Yes. Yeah. So, my question was that we want check. That means we want to know whether Euler conjecture holds for weighted homogeneous surface singularity with rational homology disk smoothing.
And that singularity is rational always?
Yes, yes. We can, indeed, we have a classification theory of this kind of singularities, and they are all rational. Yeah.
So it's not, I mean, if you take weighted homogeneous polynomial in general, it's not. So it's not the same of singularity given in the hypersurface case. It's not the same of singularity.
It's not
given
a rational singularity. The Milner fiber has a cohomology.
Ah, because of
yes,
this,
because this
of
condition.
This order of sum.
Yeah.
Okay. Of course.
Then, in order to check this conjecture, we need more building block. That means, in order to construct P modification of quotient surface singularities, we need only rational double point or class T singularity. But for this kind of singularities, we need more general singularities, which can be appeared on the P modifications. So, at first, we want to generalize the class T singularities for this. Note that any wall singularity this is a class T singularity of type 1 over n square 1 na minus 1 with relatively prime number n and a. That means t is equal to 1 here. It admits a rational homology disk smoothing. It's a very classical result because any wall singularity can be obtained by quotient out the a n minus 1 singularity by a group with n minus 1. So, and among quotient singularities, as you know, quotient singularity with this condition, such singularities are exactly wall singularity. So, the question was this one. We want to classify all Roman surface singularity with this condition. More generally, Roman surface singularity admitting a rational homology disk smoothing. Then, maybe this kind of singularity can be a building block for P resolutions for different singularities. The first result along this line was given by Stipsitz and Szabo and Wall. And they just gave a possible list of resolution graph, minimal resolution graph. There are finite number of classes which can be a minimal resolution graph of a singularity with reasonable disk smoothing. Some list is given by star shape graph. So from here, if we contract this graph, we get a rational weighted homogeneous surface singularity, but they cannot exclude this case. Certain non-star shape anyway, they just classify possible list of minimal resolution graph, not the singularity itself. And after their result, Pupal and Stipsitz applied some simplex topological method, and Dr. Fowler, who was a student of Wall, they finally classified weighted homogeneous surface singularity with rational homolith disk smoothing. In this case, for star-shaped graph with three legs, it is determined by the graph because it is taught. But we have also star-shaped graph with four legs. But in this case, we have some problem with cross ratio. But Fowler proved that there are only one cross ratio whose corresponding singularity has rational homolith disk smoothing. Yeah. And finally, with Hsiang Park and Stipsitz, we excluded this case. That means there is no singularities. No such singularities. With non-star shape graph. That means if we have more than two nodes, more than one node, then such singularity cannot admit a rational homolith smoothing. So we have a very special kind of special class of singularities, which is a generalization of Wall singularities.
Sorry, in three, what do you mean by such singularity?
Singularity with rational homolith disk smoothing. If a singularity has a minimal resolution graph, which is a non-star shape graph, then such kind of singularity cannot admit rational disk smoothing. So the question, the next question was to check whether Kolak conjecture holds for this kind of singularities. So in order to check the Kolak conjecture for that kind of singularities, at first I want find all deformations of the singularities, but this is in progress. So suppose we have a rational homology disk, weighted homogeneous surface singularity with rational homology disk smoothing. In order to find all deformations of this singularity, at first we applied some method from simplex topology in order to classify all Miller fibers. That means the general fiber of smoothing of X0. For this, we apply Pinkham's compactification. That means, since X0 is a weighted homogeneous surface singularity, this X0 is given by spec A for some graded ring A. So there is a natural compactification, say X0 bar, given by property of AT. Here, the degree of T is 1. Then, Pinkham proved that we have a new singularity on this X0 bar. That means, say, we have a singularity here, but it's not compact. But if we compactify this X0 by adding some divisor here, here E infinite is the compactifying divisor. Then there exists some cyclic quotient singularities on this E infinite. Anyway, then the theorem of Pinkham says this one. Any deformation of X0 can be extended to the deformation of this compactification. This compactification, but it satisfies one more condition, satisfying which is a this extension which is locally trivial along E infinite. That means whenever we deform this x0, we have a deformation of x0 bar, but near this E infinite, this compact fine divisor, it is a locally trivial deformation. That means we can keep these singularities. So, let me draw one picture here. Suppose we have a weighted homogeneous surface singularity.
Could you clarify? Sorry, I'm lost. Mm-hmm. The A has a C star action with all weights positive.
Yes, yes.
You add T, what does T do?
Degree 1.
T has degree 1.
Yes, yes.
So that's a genuine projective variety.
Yes, yes. So here we have a singularity x0. Suppose we have it's a smoothing. Looks like this. This is xt, or this is our Miller fiber M. Then, by Pinkham's result, we can extend this deformation to the deformation of this compactification. Here we have compactifying divisor here. It has some singularity. And for any smoothing, we have a deformation which looks like this one. Since this deformation can be locally trivial, so we have same compactifying divisor here and same singularity. This is our new XT bar, so-called compactified Miller fiber. But if we resolve these singularities, if we take minimal resolution of these singularity, then we have a new linear trio of rational curves. It is known that these new singularities should be cyclic quotient singularities, so we have a linear chain. And here, we call this new curves by E infinite hat. Then, as you see here, our Miller fiber is isomorphic to XT bar minus this compactifying divisor, E infinite. And since we take this resolution, say XT hat, then this is just XT hat minus E infinite hat. So by Pinkham's result, any Miller fiber of weighted homogeneous surface singularity can be obtained by the complement of compactifying divisor. And this compactifying divisor depends on the singularity x0 itself, not on the smoothing.
So locally trivial means locally analytically trivial in a tubular.
Yes, tube. Yes, yes.
Sorry, for this argument, you are just using the fact that which is weighted quasi homogeneous, or you are also using the fact that you have this?
No, it holds for any.
For any?
Yeah, weighted homogeneous surface singularity. Yes.
Okay.
Then we can prove that this XT hat should be a rational surface in our case. That means we can prove that this XT hat should be a rational surface. And in particular, in our case, weighted homogeneous surface singularity with rational disk smoothing, in particular, this can be obtained by from CP2 by blowing ups, not pion cross pion. So this implies that any Miller fiber can be obtained by some rational surface, including this compact fine divisor, depending on your X0. So we can classify all pairs of G and E infinite hat. Here, G is a rational surface from CP2. Which contains this E infinite hat. And it should satisfy one more condition. Since Miller fiber is Stein or Apine, this compact fine divisor should be ample inside this XT hat. So this E infinite hat supports ample divisor. In order to prove this first result, we apply the result of Mector, which says that if a surface contains positive self-intersection number curve, it should be rational. So we have a Miller fiber. Then the next step is find peer modification corresponding to the Miller fiber. For this, we apply minimal model program. That means we have, I think that we have this theorem, but I did not write anything, so this is a theorem. So we can prove that except one Miller fiber, and since we can obtain Miller fiber by complement, we can easily check its Betti number. And here the exception is a Miller fiber with the current Betti number is equal to 0. That means this is a rational homology disk. One can associate normal peer modification
Maybe it's trivial, but I don't see.
Pardon?
Why? By construction.
Why? You are
the E infinity before you blow up is ample, and the blown up thing supports an ample divisor by construction of the blow up.
Okay,
yeah, this M is a Stein, so this E infinite has should be ample should support a amplifier on this XT head. So we classify such kind of pairs. And we prove that except one Miller fiber in the classification, we can associate a normal P modification whose Miller fiber is the Kibonacci. And indeed, one can associate a unique
Does the last line mean?
Miller
fiber is the
given
one.
Does
it mean it's
diffeomorphic
to it or simple
ectomorphic? Yes, yes. For which Miller fiber is the given Miller fiber. Here we classified all Miller fiber. Yes, yes. I will sketch the proof of this theory now. And this is the main ingredient of the method is a theorem given by Hacking and Tablet and Urujua. They give a very explicit description of a flip in our case. That means, suppose we have a curve C with one wall singularity here, and suppose this curve C is a flipping curve, then we take a Kubernstein deformation of this singularity, Y singularity here. Then we have a three-pole. I'm sorry. Yes, yes. C is an irreducible curve. We have a three-fold X here on the central fiber. We have a irreducible curve C with Y singularity. Since C is a flipping curve, we can flip. This X and the flip occurs only on the central fiber. So the general fiber does not change. So if we have here XT, then the general fiber is the same. And on this central fiber, we have, suppose this situation. Take a minimal resolution of this Y singularity on this central fiber. Then we assume that we have some linear graph, and this flipping curve C intersects the final curve. And they proved that this should be minus one curve. This is central fiber. Then they proved that the central fiber of this flip should be looks like this one. Since we flip this C, we have a positive constant plus here. It may have some singularity. And the minimal resolution of this should be like this. Here, this curve C plus should be the first one. And new singularity on this C plus should be this one. Here, we obtain this graph by contracting this minus one curve continuously. So we should stop if this PT is greater than 3, but if PI should be 2 for so if PI is 2 for I greater than T, we can contract continuously. And we stop at this point. Then by contracting this singularity, we have a new Y singularity. And the first curve here becomes the C plus in this new family. And in the paper, in the joint paper with Hisang Park, Jong-il Park, and Giancarlo Lurujua, we proved that for any quotient surface singularities or for any for some weighted homogeneous surface singularities, we can apply flip so that finally, if we apply flips, or sometimes if needed, divisorial contraction, if we apply flips or divisorial contractions to the P modifications of some quotient singularities or some weighted homogeneous surface singularities, finally we have a smooth central fiber. That means by applying only flips or divisorial contractions, we can remove the singularities on the central fiber. Then, if we do not if we did not apply divisorial contraction, flip occurs only on central fiber. So, this central fiber should diffeomorphic to the general fiber. This is how we can obtain this Miller fiber by applying MMP. Here is an example. Here we have a circular quotient singularity and take its compactification, then this one is a compactifying divisor. And as I said before, we take a P resolution here, this part, and also we can compactify this P resolution by adding the same compactifying divisor. This can be proved. Then here, you can see this one is a flipping curve. It has one wall singularity on this C1. So here is C1. We apply this flip. That means we contract this C1 continuously. Then we have minus 4 curve. Only one curve here, then this one is the new C plus. And in this case, there is no new wall singularity here because we can contract continuously until this first curve. This is the first flip. And here, we have a wall singularity here and another new flipping curve C2. So we apply flip there. That means we contract minus one curve continuously. then we have minus 3 cup, and there is no another cups, so this is our new C2 plus. And finally, this central fiber does not have any singularity. But on this general fiber, we did not do anything. So this general fiber should diffeomorphic to this Y0 hat. That means this Y0 hat deformed to this YT hat. But as you see here, then this minus 3 cup degenerates to these 3 cups. That means this minus 3 cup breaks down into 3 cups. And here, you can see this minus 1 cup, say E1. Then this E1 intersects this minus 2 cup at one point. That means during this deformation, this minus 1 cup should survive, which means that we have minus 1 cup here. Then we apply divisorial contraction because this E1 deformed to this minus 1 cup at each fibers, so we contract this E1 simultaneously and so on. Then finally, we know that there should be another minus 1 cup here. This lies inside some rational surface G. So if we contract minus 1 curves continuously, you can get a smooth one. That means this configuration goes to two lines. So from CP2 with two lines, by blowing up carefully, we obtain this configuration. This implies that conversely, now I will explain this theorem. As you see in this example, by applying MMP to P resolutions, we get a rational surface containing compactifying divisor with some minus 1 curves attaching there. And in our proof, we classified surface G with E infinite hat, and we classified all the possibility of minus 1 curves attaching this E infinite hat, satisfying this condition. We classified this one. Then, for each case except this one, we know how to obtain this configuration by applying a P modification. That means we get this configuration from this P modification by MMP. Conversely, we have a very explicit algorithm construct P modification from this data for cyclic constant singularity, but we can apply the same procedure for this one. That means if we have a P modification, then by applying MMP, we get this kind of configuration. But conversely, if we have this kind of configuration, then we have an algorithm constructing P modification. And we show that two different P modification gave us two different configuration of minus 1 curves. This is a theorem. So there is only one P modification suppose Miller fiber is the given Miller fiber. But there is some problem, remained problems here, because since I said that this permutation should be normal, we have to take care of non-normal case. As you see, we have only one exception here. I think that 10 Miller fiber comes from this non-normal p modification, and I have a candidate for this one, but I cannot prove yet. Thank you.
If not, let's stand up again.